वेट अबाउट इट. यस योर लाइफ, योर लाइफ, योर लाइफ.
वी कैन स्टार्ट नाउ.
यस यस योर लाइफ.
Good. Thank you, PGS, for giving the opportunity to share the perspective of Think of Information Security differently. My name is Deepak Talwar. I am the Chief Cybersecurity Officer of Microsoft, and it is the privilege to share the priorities on the topic called Cybersecurity Beyond 2021 to bring back economic prosperity. I thought I'll share with you something which is happening across the world today. While we have seen 2020, that every software is being infused in every part of the business, making every company a software company. Wherever you are logged in from the region of UK, from the region of US, or globally, anywhere across the world, there is no company which is not a software infused company, right? You can be a manufacturing organization, you can be a healthcare organization, you can be a startup, you can be an IT company or a non-IT company. You can be at your home delivering something during COVID. All said and done, every company today is a software company or a technology company. Let me take you to a journey in 1905, where you see one of the locations. I'll not talk about where the location is, but this is how the location looks like. The people moving around, there are less of community, less of technology, less of vehicles, and a movement of people are going around in 1905, right? In somewhere in the US, in New York City, for example. And in 1925, now within a decade, you see people's coming in, and then you have less of human on the roads and more of vehicles, less of horses, more of smart vehicles. And this is how we have reached to the era of people and technology coming together. The human intelligence, the power of technology, and robotics. This whole has come up together to build the next generation, while we are seeing 2020 and beyond, in coming future. So welcome to the era of humans and machines working together. Today, when you log into the systems, you are talking not to the humans, but you are connected to humans with the technology and to the machines. The machines are so imperative that you are able to talk to those machines. You can talk to robotics, you can talk to chatbots, you can communicate, and it looks like you don't have to pick up your phone, call for a delivery, call for a, to a hospital, call for connecting to your family, call for something emergency to a human. You connect to machines. And the machines are so imperative and so fast that they can react to what you're going through. And with that, when we saw the 2020 pandemic, And the entire world got changed, and the humanity has gone connected to the world, that how do I get the vaccine? How do I live the life the way 2020 has given us? And that's where we have also seen across the world a growth in cybersecurity with the threats coming very near to us, right? Email phishing. Business email compromise, when you get an email and you get compromised by clicking on a link, right? Or to a click on a link and you download something and you see, oh, this is not a COVID vaccine. And I got, through someone who is spying on me and taken a, toll on my credentials, taken a toll on my email ID, I got hacked for everything possible, right? So the bad actors are using, sophisticated tracks. The digital estate where you're living in has got into a lot of insecurity. And on top of that, how are you going to mitigate these risks? How are you going to make sure that the security is taken care of, right? So in this world of pandemic, in 2020, it is not a matter of where you are today. It is a matter of what you're going to look into the larger horizon in 2020 to 2025. How are you going to survive when you have, doctors, prescriptions, healthcare at your tips? But when you're logging in, you don't know whether it is the right appropriate credentials to log in, where you are getting the right medicines, where you're looking into, where you are getting into the right grocery which you're delivering, or the transactions which we do day in, day out. Is it worth doing the transaction on that time, right? So healthcare is a top target for cyber criminals. The threats and the key point of vulnerabilities are like phishing. You get an email, you click on that link thinking it's a COVID update. The time you click on that link, you get downloaded with something which is relevant to your family. It talks about you, it talks about your wife, it talks about your parents, your children, and it looks like very genuine. And when you go deep into it, you become a part of the an infection chain, and there your system or your credentials are compromised. It can be care coordination, it can be care planning, it can be case management, it can be patient information, it can be data retention. Data is the core of everything today. So you talk to the devices, through devices, you talk to clinicians, radiologists, pharmacists, insurance company, medical records are being updated, and the labs where you're getting tested. Each and everything as part of the healthcare can be compromised at any given point of time. So with that, I would like to bring in the theory of being protected, being resilient, so that you can protect, detect, and respond. First, you need to protect your assets, your technology, your system, if you're an enterprise, as a startup, or even if you are a consumer. How do you protect your identity? How do you build the next level of security when you're logging to your systems, to your laptop, to your smartphones? If at all you get into the detect situation in an enterprise, how do we detect what is there in the system, on the network? And then how do you respond to those attacks is very, very imperative, right? So we are living in an era where you are connected to millions of devices, users, Facebook, LinkedIn, you are connected to Twitter, you are connected to WhatsApp, you are connected to Teams, Zoom, Google, anything you talk about, and you are live 24/7. I can tell you on this call, none of you are able to disconnect from your Wi-Fi. None of you are able to, not any of us are actually logging off and, shut down the systems in the midnight. Your Wi-Fi's are on 24/7. Your systems are on. You are being spied by somebody you don't know. You are connected through Bluetooth, you don't know. You don't disconnect your Bluetooth before sleeping, right? You don't do, right? So with this scenario, it is very, very important that somebody who is the subject matter expertise on security is to take care of it when you're out of your desk, when you're out of your bench. And with that, the importance is what are the key security challenges in government, in industries. So there are three important things when we look into large enterprise, right? Cybersecurity concern, that is defending against the persistent adversaries, the online fraud, that digital transformation, which we are going through every organization, whether it is work from home, people going in a hybrid mode, or people in the office, how do they transform to the new digital world, including the cloud era? And then the last piece, which is very, very important and critical to look into, is every organization today or tomorrow cannot just do anything on the work from home, cannot just connect to the family and professionalism to the same platform. So what are those regulatory compliance? How do you assess and audit your systems? How do you comply into your network? How do you comply into the system whom you're logging in? Are you logging from a Windows 7? Are you logging from a weak network? Are you logging from a weak Wi-Fi? And when you connect to the corporate network, are you taking care of the data? Is the data security from the organization perspective and even from the individual is taken care of, right? So at Microsoft, our mission is to empower every person and every organization on the planet to achieve more. Now, what does that mean to the people on the call? It is very, very important for the people on the call to understand that if you're embracing on a journey of a technology, do you empower security as just to be a product update? Do you empower security to take care of what you are in, keeping at your laptop and desktops, or you are consolidating and making sure that security is not only about technology, it is about people, process, and technology altogether? If you are an enterprise on the call, how do you build the zero trust architecture, right? Zero trust architecture, the framework is all about you never trust, always verify. Each and every person connected to the network, offline and online, how do you trust the system? How do you trust the process and policies you create on, right? So, and how do you validate authentication? How do you authenticate? If I get a banking transaction and I log into my system, I should get an OTP or a fingerprint. And when I do that, I should be able to validate at a multi-level, architecture way. It's something like getting a 6-digit PIN, then authenticating through my fingerprint, and then authenticating through my facial recognition or through email or whatnot, multi-factor authentication. So security should not be looked into silo. It should be looked into security, compliance, and identity. So security is one part of the pillar. Are you compliant to the architecture? Are you compliant to the organizational need? Are you compliant to what you're utilizing in your devices? And then identity. Identity has become very, very important and imperative in this living world. Identity means how you are sharing your SSN number, how you are sharing your security identity, how you are sharing your credentials, how you are sharing your credit card details, banking details, how you are transacting. Each and every aspect has become very, very important in the current pandemic time and future ahead in 2020 to 2025. My urge to all of you on the call is when you start your enterprise, how do you connect to the network? How do you access data? How do you store data? How do you retain data? You need to follow three things. One, the way you compile and comprehensively keep your data for your corporate network. How do you share? The way you compile and share your data when you are accessing the system at your personal laptop and desktop and smartphones in your shared network environment. How do you maintain it? Try to find out the best practices so that you are able to minimize the attack surface area. The idea is to minimize the attack surface area. And the third one is, while you get 30 seconds to a minute while you are connected to your network devices, responding to an email, downloading a link, or something which is very, very known to your community, to your work, are you responding quickly or you are waiting 30 seconds to clean your hands, to clean your mind, and to clean your network to see what you are clicking at, what you're connecting at? By this, you are able to empower your network, your systems, and how you're able to do that. Now, before I conclude, I would like to, bring on some of the aspects for the larger community which are working on AI, artificial intelligence, IoT, Internet of Things, rather IOE, Internet of Everything, and then to the blockchain. Each of these technologies are going to challenge the world, how we are creating the use cases. Let me tell you, in today's world, across the world, in the UK, in US, the Southeast Asia, India region, the South African region, the other part of the to the planet, anywhere, artificial intelligence, Internet of Things, blockchain, right, or cloud computing, or quantum computing, these are going to be generating the new use cases which we have not seen today. Even today, the use cases are not going to work the way they are. Even it's only 10 to 20% what the use cases we have created today. 80% are unexplored. We don't even know what we can do in agriculture. We don't even know by utilizing AI with security or quantum computing how much energy we are going to save. we don't even know in the multitude of millions of people roaming around on the road, by AI you are able to capture the face recognition or facial recognition and able to justify it, to solve the problems of law and justice, to solve the problems of defense and intelligence. You don't even know how the drones can work together and can build together, how we can collect the data, and it can impact the nation, it can impact technology, and can impact the aviation industry, and so on and so forth. So there are millions of use cases which needs to be evolved. And with that, there is a possibility to explore each and everything on the technology. And especially when you are looking into cybersecurity, this is an era of security, compliance, and identity to be looked together as an integrated approach. With that, I'll stop here and thank you for your time and the opportunity to hear from me. Mohsin, over to you.
Thank you so much, Deepak, for such an insightful presentation. Thank you so much for being the part of Global IT Security Conference. It's a pleasure to have you, and I will request my audience to ask questions about his presentation on the main chat. Deepak is here to answer your questions. Thank you so much, Deepak, to be the part of it. Thank you so much. Thank you. Now, we will be heading towards our next presentation, which will be of Patrick Hamilton, who is working as a Chief Technical Officer in Internet 2.0. So within a few minutes, he will be live for his presentation for his insightful session. I hope you all are having a very good time. Thank you so much. We'll be right back after a few minutes. Thank you.